Sasahara way down the order in this race. Need to make up a number of places to try and cement his position. Now he has a healthy margin over Kevin Jörg going into this race, but Jörg much better position in terms of starting. So here is the grid in full for you. Jörg, Delatraz, Daravala, then it's Gill, Eastwood, Zaruba, Noble, O'Keefe, before it's Habsburg, and then Ukio Sasahara is P10 on the grid, then it's Vantor P11, Mazapan is P12. Of course, there is the Drivers' Championship. There's also the Rookies 2. Some 18 nationalities represented here, 8 rookies. Champion at the end of the season gets a test in Formula Renault 3.5 and also free entry into the 2-litre Euro Cup. We're here at the Red Bull Ring with Spa, Assen, Nürburgring, Hockenheim still to come. The 10th season of this Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. 6 drivers took part in this that take part in Formula One. Great category, the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. So, top three yesterday, Jörg, Delatraz and Daruvala. Then it was O'Keefe and Gill and Habsburg and Vantor and De Forney. And Mazapan and Ukio Sasahara just into the points, finishing P10 yesterday. So the car's weaving from side to side to try and generate some heat into the tyres before this race. And the race yesterday was really, really enjoyable. Looking for much of the same today. So formation lap just about done. Team cars on the grid. There is the Ferdinand Habsburg car, local driver, running for Fortec Motorsports, was fourth in the Northern European Cup 1.6 in 2014. And there is Kevin Jörg. See how Daravula has just lined up the car, look, on the second row of the grid, ready to dive into the middle, if he possibly can, this staggered grid for Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. It was in the pit box, but definitely angled the car for an attack to try and get between Jörg and Delatraz up to the first Castrol Edge turn. Green flag from the marshal at the back means race steward will ignite the lights, and when the lights go out to green, we will be away and racing. Jump start from someone, possibly. And there you can see that the lining up of the car didn't really work in terms of splitting Jörg and Delatraz as they head up towards the first turn. And it is Jörg that maintains as one, two, two go running very, very wide. But there's a gaggle of three cars behind Delatraz. Who is going to win that little battle as they head up towards the Remus turn right now? The marshal looks on. Through the Remus turn they go, several run wide. Thankfully there's no contact and everyone gets through the first sequence without too much of a problem. Kevin Jörg though looking very, very good here. Delatraz is going backwards now. Not what Delatraz needs. Goes into this leading the championship. It's the best possible result that he can get. Cars all snake through this roller coaster section through the vert curve and head up towards the Rindt turn before Red Bull Mobile, which is the final turn on the circuit. And a lap will be completed. 25-minute race. Moving up the order there and making a move was Vantor. Dries Vantor in the all-yellow machine. Running out very, very wide is Daruvala, who has managed to get past Delatraz, who is P3, Gill is P4. Then in P5, it's Charlie Eastwood. Thank you. And just look at what Kevin Jürg has been able to do whilst they've all battled behind him. He's just been able to get up the road. Lock up there from Davala. We saw him locking up so much yesterday. The car was suffering from so much understeer. From our position high in the comms booth, we can see one retired. I think it's Mazepan. So several cars are lock up then. So Mazepan out right at the start of this race. Yes, confirmation on screen. It is Nikita Mazepan, the Josef Kaufmann, youngest driver in Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup, who is out, just 16 years of age. And there you can see the number 16 car, and Nikita Mazepan, whose race is done. Damage to the front left-hand side there, you can see. Where was the contact then? Ah, just caught the back end of that car. And that, sadly, spells the end of his race. Jürg then with 2.4 seconds over Daruvala. Look at this battle going on behind, and right in the mix there is the local driver, Ferdinand Habsburg. Currently running P9. And just ahead of Habsburg, Keith and Sasahara. Whoa, and he's going to be run out onto the grass. So the battle between O'Keefe and Ukio Sasahara saw Sasahara out onto the grass. And now Habsburg is on the grass as well. Manages to get back onto the tarmac and control that. Big, big lock up there. And lots of dust being kicked up there. Have we got a car off? Trying to wave our hands and see through the smoke. So the local driver, number 62, is under investigation, we're being told. Ferdinand Habsburg, also under investigation, is Callan O'Keefe. So there is Callan O'Keefe. As the rest of the pack come through. All this playing into the hands of Jürg, who is 2.7 seconds up the road from Daruvala. Then it's Delatraz and Gill and Eastwood and Zaruba, and O'Keefe and Sasahara is P8 with Habsburg and DeForney and Vantor and Noble. Osque is P13. Up towards the Remus turn, then comes our race leader. Kevin Jürg took the win yesterday. Habsburg now lining up and trying to go around the outside of the Kyo Sasahara car. That wasn't going to work, and didn't. As now he lines up again and lurking behind is DeForney lining them up. Trying to go through the inside. Sasahara there, very, very busy. Habsburg has done what he needed to do. And now, having done so, despite being under investigation, looks very, very quick. So there is Kevin Jürg, just see the back of his car as he crosses the timing line. Then P2 and P3, very close, Daruvala and Delatraz. Then it's Gill and Eastwood and Zaruba and O'Keefe and Habsburg. Sasahara and DeForney. So lining up Daruvala now. Here comes Delatraz. Around the kink there as they head up towards the Remus turn, and what a dive up the inside there from Delatraz. He's got the inside line, but Daravalo was carrying more speed and was able to keep the momentum up and deny Delatraz. But valiant move from Delatraz there as he dived to the inside. Now, Delatraz has got Gil for company, and he's right in the middle of this, as being hunted as well as hunting himself. Here's a replay of the start, and there, well, that was a jump start from our local driver. Number 9 is under investigation. Sasahara for pushing another car. And thankfully, they all managed to go through turn 1. Relatively unscathed. Lots of jostling for position, as you would expect. Back end of the Sasahara car, we see. Replay of the start. Jurgis just crossed the timing line in the race live, some 4 seconds. Giulinier over Daravalo, and it's Daravalo then and Delatraz that we watch now through the Remus turn. And it was through that Remus turn yesterday where Daravalo was locking up lots. Doesn't seem to be the case today. The engineers have worked on the car overnight. We heard his engineers say, how many flat spots have I got on that tyre? And Daravala's answer was, well, the car is just understeering everywhere. So Jurg, Daravalo, then it's Delatraz, and Gil Eastwood. So car number 62 gets a drive-through penalty for the jump start that we called right at the beginning of the race. So the local star Ferdinand Habsburg, there he is, right in the center of your screen, has got a drive-through penalty that has to be taken within 3 laps of being notified. So that's going to compromise his race. Was running in P8, being told that Callan O'Keefe, there's no further action following that investigation that was going on. So in for his drive-through straight away is Habsburg, deciding to get it done as soon as possible. 15 and a half minutes, and we saw that right at the beginning, and there was no question of that jump start actually help him in the end, and further hampered him now by the drive-through penalty, of course. Okay, here comes the battle for P2 then, through the Remus turn, as Daravala's really got the measure of Delatraz at the moment. Delatraz is able to close up under braking, but it's such a difficult turn that it's a great overtake opportunity, but you've got to get it nailed absolutely perfectly, because you're turning in and you're going uphill as well. He is under pressure now. Daravalo has once again another dive from Delatraz, but Delatraz, just if he could just nose up the inside, that would probably be enough. They're only tenths apart. Whilst these two continue to battle, it's great for Kevin Jurg, who's just able to get up the road and is just under 5 seconds ahead. Callan O'Keefe, we see there, running down there in P7. Race leader goes through. Here comes P2 and P3 then, and they're as close as they've ever been. There's the last 3 laps between Daravalo and Delatraz. There's race leader. Short, sharp races, these, full of excitement, the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. Jurg, Daravalo, Delatraz, Gil, Eastwood. And then running in P6 is Josef Zaruba for the AVF team. Just for the moment. And there comes the first lockup we've seen from Daravalo. Race was littered with them yesterday. Delatraz maintains his pressure on him, certainly. At the moment, Daravalo is not being fazed by it at all. First season in cars for Daravalo. carts previously and is a Sahara Force India junior driver. A talent to watch out for, that is for sure. Being hounded all the way, though, by Louis Delatraz, who's in his third season, really needs to make this season count. He's got to be the champion. Under 3 tenths between them. He's son of the former F1 and Le Mans driver Jean-Denis Delatraz. Won here in 2014, but Delatraz knows that this is the season of make or break. At the moment, he does lead the points. 121, plays 106 of Ukio Sasahara, who closest to him in the points is running down there in P9 at the moment and finished P10 yesterday. So just takes a look up the inside, does Delatraz, but nothing doing. So from a points perspective, Onisa Sahara is where he is, and Delatraz can stay in one of those podium positions and always going to have the points advantage. Daravala has been a real star at the moment, and he's not yielding to the pressure that's being placed upon him by Delatraz in P3. In fact, if anything, the pressure from Delatraz has gone away momentarily. Just takes the car a little bit further back and allows it to perhaps cool down a bit before he'll go for another charge on that P2 Daravala car. Best lap, interestingly, on lap 8 was a 132.108, which came from Habsburg, who of course has had to have that drive-through penalty. Race leader goes through. Here's P2 and P3. 11 minutes left to run as we cross the timing line for P2 and P3. Now, the advantage that Jörg has is 4.3 seconds. And just 3 tenths between Daravala and Delatraz. And this, the battle well worth watching at the moment, as once again now, Delatraz just turns the wick up a bit and keeps the pressure on Daravala, the Force India Junior. Trezza really close behind him. Now the run down to the Schloss Gold turn, where if you can just get your nose ahead before the right-hander into Schloss Gold, but Delatraz is certainly not close enough to be able to do so. That was yesterday where we saw so many lockups from Daravala, but not the case today. The team have worked hard on that car to tune out the understeer that he was suffering with. Delatraz follow him all the way there. The last three laps, the difference between Daravala and Delatraz in terms of the lap times and gap between P2 and P3. Around the Rint turn, downhill section to Red Bull Mobile. And start another lap. Now, is Delatraz as close to try and line up a move going into the Castrol Edge turn? No, he isn't. Is he going to save it for the long run now? There's a Sasahara. Yields to De Forni. And back to this, and no, Delatraz still not able to take anything to him. Callan O'Keefe, the Fortec driver. Long way around the outside for Sasahara there. His battle with De Forni continues. Max De Forni, the ART junior driver. First season in this. 8 minutes left to run. Kirk with a 4.5 second margin up the front. And just see how Ukio Sasahara having to use opposite lock to try and control that car. Max DeForney had the inside line and then is run out wide. Shot in replay. Delatraz does dive up the inside now, and is the switchback going to come from Davale? He tries, but Delatraz had shut the door, so now Davale going around the outside, heading up towards this Remus turn. They are absolutely side by side, and Daravala is carrying plenty of momentum now. If he switches to the inside now and can get the inside line for Schloss Gold, maybe he can win that place back. Delatraz has got the inside line covered. It's all offering an opportunity to Gil in P4 as well, who's trying to join in this battle. Well, Delatraz have been lining that up for several laps. Here it is again in slow-mo. The draft off the car, dives up the inside, heavy braking. You can see there where Daravala tried to get the switch back but was not able to carry enough momentum to so do, and Delatraz was able to shut the door. So his next problem is going to be in the shape of the Alex Gill Fortec car, who's raced in the Formula Renault BARC previously. Interestingly, a black and white flag being shown to Sasahara for failing to manage the track limits. Jörg with just under 5 seconds advantage at the lead. And it's Gil to the outside, Daravala on the inside. They are absolutely very nearly locking wheels together there. Now, this is where Gil needs to get the inside line. Daravala's going to squeeze him out. No, he's not. He has to yield. This looks like it could be another place lost for Daravala, the Force India Junior. But he's remaining committed around the outside line. Just gets squeezed out. If he could have held on to that, he'd be in the perfect position for the next turn, which is a left-hander, but he wasn't able to do so, so he loses another place. And lurking behind is Charlie Eastwood now for AVF also. And behind Eastwood is Ukio Sasahara. Five minutes left to run. So now Delatraz has moved up to P2. After lap of trying, Jörg crosses the timing line. There is Frederik Habsburg, the local driver, who is back into the race having served that drive-through penalty. Really colourful scheme on the number 62 car run by Fortec Motorsports. He was fourth in NEC in 2014. So no question about it that Alex Gill is quicker, leaving Daravala behind. P1, P2, here comes the P3 car, and behind that battle's going on between Eastwood and Zaruba. Lots of cars being warned about track limits now, including Darius Osque and Henrik Chavez. So they're the AVF car of Joseph Saroba. Lap 13 saw the fastest lap from Delatraz, 131.292. Gaggle of cars have been jostling. Really, really enjoyable. enjoyable to watch. It's Jurg, Delatraz, then it's Gil, Daruvala, but then it's Eastwood, Zaruba and O'Keefe. And O'Keefe just takes a look. So those two absolutely, virtually welded together. As you can see, there is the kink before they get to the Remus turn. They go side by side now. This is the battle for P6. So it's O'Keefe on the inside. Now this is where, and O'Keefe makes sure that there is insufficient room. Because if you can remain alongside, you're then perfectly placed for the turn in for the next one. And Yukio Sasahara trying to buy into this as well if he possibly can. In the number 9 car, there is number 20, Zaruba. Josef Zaruba took a... Now just 1 3/4 minutes left. And Delatraz is quick. 1:31.094. He's a full 0.4 quicker than Jurg, but it's all come too late with just 1.5 minutes left to run. Jurg should have this all sorted. So the black and white flag just being reeled back in, but has been shown. Here's race leader Kevin Jurg. And Delatraz in P2. Alex Gill all of a sudden has Daruvala back again, and Daruvala is not able to remain committed there, but P3, the final podium place, could be up for grabs here. Gil, who managed to get past Daruvala. Daruvala is fighting back now. Look at this. This is so, so very close. Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. We're watching the battle for P3 between Alex Gil and Johan Daruvala. Through the rint turn, Red Bull Mobile is next. So Jurg crosses the line, Delatraz crosses the line, and then it is Gil and Daruvala and Eastwood. Eastwood trying to get in here too, so too O'Keefe. Daruvala runs a bit wide, he's now going to have to try and shut the door. Is he able to do so? Yes, he is. This plays into the hands of Gil. You've got this bunch here, and trying to get the best of this is Callan O'Keefe. He runs around the outside, runs out wide, is able to carry the speed though. And we are on the final lap, and I just think the opportunity that Daruvala had as they go 3 abreast now in this battle here. O'Keefe right in the middle of that sandwich. Whoa! Sasahara is in there as well. And just look at Yukio Sasahara trying to just unsettle the driver in front. Focus on Kevin Jurg though as he heads to take a checkered flag and make it 2 out of 2 at the Red Bull Ring. So Jurg takes the win from Delatraz. There's going to be a whole train of cars next. Heading towards the timing line goes Gil, then it's Daruvala, then it's Eastwood, O'Keefe, Zaruba and Sasahara. With Tafoni and Noble rounding out the top 10 with Vantur and Osque, Chavez and Frederiksen. With Meyer and Marecki. Ptolemy Moretzky. So there is Kevin Jurg. What a weekend he is having here at the Red Bull Ring. Another brilliant race from the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. There is the checkered flag replay. Well, Delatraz, once he had managed to get past Arevalo, was up the road, but he left himself too much work to do in the final stages of the race. So, race winner, Kevin Jurg. Josef Kaufmann driver, P3 in the points on 75. Now, Ukio Sasahara has finished down the order. So here is the order. It's Jurg, it's Delatraz and Gill and Darivala and Eastwood O'Keefe. Zaruba, Defourny, Noble, Vantor, Osque and Chavez. Ukio Sasahara being shown as finishing in P18, so perhaps called that wrong, and it wasn't Sasahara that was in that mix. So what that basically means is it's great news for Kevin Jurg, who's taken some real points out of Ukio Sasahara. And there, our race winner, no mistake in that, Kevin Jurg, taken two out of two here at the Red Bull Ring. So the Josef Kaufmann team taking P1 and P2. Fortec with P3 and Alex Gill. So, Kevin being congratulated by Delatraz there.
Yeah, but now was really good last. We take it. Yeah,
no, I know. So, nice to hear, just listen to those engineers and what they say. So there, zoom in to the race-winning car in the sight of the Red Bull here. Top two podium places, exactly the same as yesterday. P3 is changed, though, as it's Alex Gill rather than Jehan Daruvala, who was on the third step of the podium yesterday. And the drivers are heading up to the podium as we speak. And we'll be up there momentarily. So here we see some replays of some of the action from the Formula Renault 2-litre Northern European Cup. Habsburg was in the mix, that's for sure. Sometimes for the wrong reasons, unfortunately. Ferdinand Habsburg having to serve a drive-through penalty. there, the checkered flag on Kevin Jurg, making it 2 out of 2 at the Red Bull Ring. Up next, it's Spa after the third race here, which is still to come a little bit later this afternoon, around about 4:45. There's Alex Gill then. Louis Delatraz then. Kevin Jurg takes the win.